Dear students, in this lesson, the author used past perfect tense in many sentences. To understand how past perfect tense is used and what rules govern past perfect tense, if we study the following sentences, we could understand. So before that, if we want to understand past perfect tense and simple past, before that we should have little knowledge of tenses, how tenses are formed. Today I am going to revise the tenses which we have discussed in our lower classes. Those are, as per previous discussion, it is clear there are mainly three tenses: present, past, future. In each main tense there are four sub tenses, namely simple, continuous, perfect, perfect continuous. Simple tense, where in present simple the verb will be in its root form or base form. In generally we call it as V1 form of verb. So we practiced verb in three forms, that is V1, V2 and V3. For example, if we take the verb play, play is V1 form, that is present form. Played is V2 form, that is past form. And played is V3 form, that is past participle form. In this verb, we don't find any difference between V2 and V3, past tense and past participle. So, for example, if we take another verb like eat, eat is the present tense and ate is the past tense, eaten is the past participle. There is a clear demarcation between past tense and past participle. Past participle is formed by adding en to V1 form of verb, that is eat. N is added so that past participle is formed. So by that we could understand V3 form of verbs. For some verbs it is expressed in ed form, and clearly for some other verbs it is expressed as in N. So we could understand if it is expressed in ed also, we should take it as N. That is past participle form of a verb. In all perfect tenses, either it is present or past or future, this past participle form of verb is used. So how past participle form of, when past participle form of verb is used, it forms the perfect tense. What helping verb does it take before it? It takes the have form. So to understand this perfect, how perfect tenses are formed, how progressive tenses are formed, and how perfect progressive tenses are formed. So here I used another term, progressive. Progressive is the alternate word for continuous tense. So just an example, we will see. I'll simply tell you, a verb has only two tenses, that is present and past. You may get a doubt that how future tense is formed. Before V1 form of verb, if we keep will or shall modals, if we keep, it forms the future tense. But there is no separate future tense for a verb. So now it is clear to us. In simple tenses, just example, if we take the verb play, play itself is the simple and played is the past, and will or shall play is the future. So simple tense is over. Now to understand continuous or progressive tense, we will have the helping verb be form. So already it is very clear to us that the various be forms, what are the various be forms? Be forms are am, is, are, was, were. And you know the clear demarcation between these verbs. Am, is, are present be forms. Was and were are past be forms. In this also we have another division like am, is, was. These are singular be forms, and are, were are plural be forms. Now it is clear, singular, plural and past and present be forms. So with the help of be forms, continuous tense is formed. Simply I can say, Continuous in English, all continuous tenses is formed with the help of be. I'll say being. It is continuous tense in English. Say, in simple present tense, we have formed a sentence like I play chess. Just example, it is simple present tense. What is the continuous tense of this sentence? I told you be form it will take. I subject, it will be as it is. Based on the subject, we take be form. So what be form in present tense? I takes am, I am. What is the verb? Play is the verb. As before the play, we brought am automatically in continuous tense. The ing is added to play. So it becomes playing, present participle. I am playing chess. It is the continuous, present continuous. In similar way, in past tense also, I past be form singular, past be form was. I was. Same playing chess. In future tense, I, future will, be as it is, it's a base form be, I will be. Automatically the play becomes playing, I will be playing chess. So future continuous is form. This way, total, either it is present or past or future, continuous tense or progressive tense is formed by the combination of be form. Being is the progressive in English. So how continuous tense is formed? Similarly, perfect tense is formed in English with have, n. We know it, have is another auxiliary. So what are the various have forms? Have, has, had. Among these three have forms, have and has are present have forms. Had is the past have form. So have, has, what is the difference between have and has? It is very clear as that yes, has comes with third person singular subjects. Third person singular subjects. So remaining present and past with other subjects. So just now we will see how perfect tense are formed in English. So I have, perfect means compulsory we have to take have. With the subject I, it comes have. I have played chess. This is present perfect. Similarly, here played is not simple past form. It is past participle form. Earlier I told you that how 8 past tense and eaten past participle. Similarly, in some verbs, whenever either be form or have form comes before these forms, automatically they are past participle forms. One thing we have to remember here, in English, past participle form of verbs are used in one condition, that is in perfect tenses. Other conditions, it is passivized sentences. In perfect sentences, this past participle form of verb takes have forms before it, and in passive form of sentences, it takes be form before it. Clearly, we should understand, whenever there is have and be forms before V3 form of verb, that verb is past participle form of verb. So it is clearly noted with some verbs, V3 and V2 are differentiated. Some verbs, there is no difference, and we could understand whether it is past participle or past form by looking at the helping verb before it. I have played chess, it is the present perfect tense. Similarly, it is very easy. What is the past tense of have form? Had is the past tense. I had played chess. Similarly, in future tense, I will have played chess. In these three tenses, present, past and future, the played, the verb used in it is the past participle form of verb. The ed, past tense is formed by adding ed to play. The ed itself in past participle forms can be remembered as n form. So, simply we can say in English, perfect tense is have n. Have n is the past participle mark and have is the perfect marker. Have n is the perfect tense in English. So the third tense automatically formed by using both be plus ing and have plus n, that is perfect progressive, present perfect progressive, past perfect progressive and future perfect progressive. How they are formed? In present perfect progressive, I have be, both helping verbs have come, and the n which comes along with have is added to be, so it becomes been. I have been. And the ing which comes with the be is added to play. I have been playing chess. This is the present perfect progressive form. And in past perfect progressive form, I had been. I had been being. That is, I had been playing chess. That is past perfect tense. Perfect progressive. Similarly, in future perfect progressive, future will have perfect, be progressive, been, have been, I will have been, and the ing with be is added to play. I will have been playing chess. This is future perfect progressive. Now it is clear to us. So what is simple past and what is past perfect tense? Now we will see what are the various past perfect tenses used in our lesson, The Journey. The author here used both simple past and past perfect tenses. And what are the conditions and rules that govern this past perfect tense, and under what conditions we have to use this past perfect tense, we will see here.